Heavenly Father, we come before you today in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus Christ, seeking your divine protection against all evil forces that may come against us. We acknowledge that you, God, are our refuge and fortress, and we stand firm in the power of your word, which is our shield and defense. In the name of Jesus, I declare over you the full covering of God's protection, and I speak the authority of his word over every evil scheme that seeks to harm you in Jesus' name. We stand firm in the truth of Psalm 91, which declares that he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Psalm 91 verse 1. Do endeavor to subscribe to this channel in order for you to get access to more notification of prayers from this channel. Let's pray. As it is written in Psalm 91 verse 4, he will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness shall be your shield and rampart. I declare over you that you are covered by the mighty wings of God, and his faithfulness surrounds you as an unbreakable shield in the name of Jesus. Every arrow of evil that is directed towards you is deflected by God's protection. I declare over you that no scheme of the enemy will penetrate the protective barrier of God's mighty presence. You are safe under the wings of the Almighty, where no harm can touch you. The word of God is our sword and our defense. Psalm 18 verse 2 reminds us that the Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. My God is my rock in whom I take refuge, my shield, and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I declare that the Lord is your stronghold, your place of safety in every storm, in the name of Jesus. No power of darkness will break through the fortress that God has built around you. I declare that God is your rock, unshakable and immovable, and no evil force will be able to uproot you from a secure foundation, in the name of Jesus. According to Psalm 27 verse 1, which says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?" I declare over you that fear has no place in your life, for the Lord is your salvation. I declare over you that every fear, every anxiety, every dread of the unknown is cast down in the presence of God's peace. The Lord is the stronghold of your life, and no evil, no demonic power, no fear will be able to stand against you in Jesus' name. I declare over you the boldness and courage that comes from trusting in God's mighty hand of protection. You will not be moved by fear because the Lord stands as your shield and strength. The word of God, as promised in Psalm 121 verses 7 to 8, say, "The Lord will keep you from all harm. He'll watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forever." I declare over you that the Lord watches over every step you take in Jesus' name. I declare over you that whether you are going out or coming in, the hand of the Lord is upon you and no evil will befall you. I declare over you that the plans of the enemies are frustrated and every trap set before you is exposed and dismantled by the power of God. You are guarded by the eternal watchfulness of the Lord, who never sleeps or slumbers. His protection surrounds you like a fortress, and no evil will touch your life in the name of Jesus. Psalm 144 verse 1 says, "Praise be to the Lord my rock, who trains my hands for war, my fingers for battle." I declare over you that God equips you to fight spiritual battles with victory assured in Jesus' name. I declare that you will not be defenseless against the attacks of the enemy, for the Lord has trained your hands for war and given you spiritual authority in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that you will stand strong in the face of every evil scheme, knowing that the Lord fights on your behalf. No weapon of darkness will prevail, for God has armed you with the power of His Spirit. You are more than a conqueror through Christ who strengthens you in Jesus' name. The word of God in Psalm 34 verse 7 declares, "The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear Him, and He delivers them." I declare that the angels of the Lord are encamped around you, providing supernatural protection from every form of evil in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that the Lord's mighty angels are stationed around your home, your family, and everything that concerns you in Jesus' name. Every plot of darkness is thwarted by the heavenly host that surrounds you. I declare over you that the Lord's divine protection is impenetrable and you are shielded from every attack of the enemy. I declare over you that God's angels will deliver you from danger and bring you safely through every trial in Jesus' name. The word of God in Psalm 46 verse 1 declares, God is our refuge and strength and ever-present help in trouble. I declare that in every moment of trouble, God is your refuge and strength. I declare over you that no matter what storms you face, the Lord will be with you, providing protection and guidance in Jesus' name. I declare over you that when the enemy rises up like a flood, the Lord will raise a standard against him in Jesus' name. You will not be overwhelmed by the trials and attacks of the enemy, for the Lord is your ever-present help. I declare over you that God's strength will sustain you and his refuge will shield you from every harm in Jesus' name. God's word in Psalm 91 verses 10 to 11 gives us the assurance that no harm will overtake you, no disaster will come near your tent, for he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. I declare that no harm will overtake you, no disaster will come near your dwelling place in Jesus' name. I declare that the Lord's angels are commanded to guard you in all your ways. Whether you walk through danger, uncertainty, or darkness, the Lord's angels will protect and preserve you. I declare over you that your household is safeguarded by the Lord, and no calamity, no attack, no disaster will touch you in Jesus' name. The blood of Jesus covers your home, your family, and everything that pertains to you in the name of Jesus. In Psalm 23 verse 4, God's word says, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. I declare over you that even in the darkest moments, the presence of the Lord is with you in Jesus' name. I declare that you will not fear even though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, for the Lord is your guide and comforter. I declare over you that the rod and staff of the Lord will lead you out of every dark valley, and no evil will overcome you in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that the Lord's comforting presence surrounds you, giving you peace and assurance in the name of Jesus. God's word in Psalm 104 verse 4 says, keep me safe, Lord, from the hands of the wicked. Protect me from the violent who devise ways to trip my feet. I declare that the Lord keeps you safe from the hands of the wicked. I declare that every plot and device of the enemy that seeks to trip your feet is dismantled. I declare that no violence, no wickedness, no trap of the enemy will succeed against you. I declare that the Lord's mighty hand protects you. No evil plan will prosper in Jesus' name. Every scheme of the wicked is exposed and nullified by the power of God, and you walk in divine protection. Psalm 121 verse 3 assures us that he will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. I declare over you that the Lord will not let your foot slip. I declare over you that every step you take is guided by the Lord, and you will not stumble or fall in the name of Jesus. I declare that God watches over you day and night, and no moment of weakness or vulnerability will give the enemy a foothold in Jesus' name. I declare over you that the constant and unwavering protection of the Lord surrounds you, and every attempt of the enemy to cause you to fall is thwarted. The Lord is your guard, and he will not let you sleep or falter. As it is written in Psalm 59 verses 1 to 2, which says, deliver me from my enemies, O God. Be my fortress against those who are attacking me. Deliver me from evildoers and save me from those who are after my blood. I declare over you that God is delivering you from every enemy that seeks to harm you. I declare over you that every attack against you, whether physical or spiritual, is met with the power of God's deliverance. The Lord is your fortress, impenetrable by any force of darkness. I declare that no evildoer, no power of the enemy, and no spiritual attack will succeed, for the Lord fights on your behalf. You are delivered by the hand of God from every enemy that seeks to destroy you. in Jesus' name. In Psalm 34 verse 9, your word says, "The righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers him from them all." I declare that even in the midst of many troubles, the Lord is delivering you from them all in Jesus' name. I declare that no trouble, no adversity, no challenge will overcome you, for the Lord is your deliverer. I declare over you that God is faithful to rescue you from every trial, and His deliverance is at work in your life. I declare over you that no matter how many troubles come your way, the Lord will bring you through them all, safe and victorious, in the name of Jesus. God's word in Psalm 125 verse 2 gives us this promise. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds His people both now and forevermore. I declare over you that the Lord surrounds you like the mountains that encircle Jerusalem in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that the protection of God is eternal and unshakable. I declare over you that the enemy cannot penetrate the divine barrier of God's protection that surrounds you. Just as the mountain stands firm, so does the Lord's protection around your life, your family, your future. You are encompassed by the love and defense of the Almighty God. I declare over you that the blood of Jesus covers you, your family, your home, and everything that pertains to you. I declare that every evil plot, every curse, and every attack of the enemy is broken by the power of the cross in the name of Jesus. The Lord is your protector, your shield, and your fortress, and no evil will be able to touch you. I declare over you that you walk in the victory of God's protection, and His angels surround you, guarding you in all your ways, in the name of Jesus. God's word in Psalm 64 verses 2 to 4 declare, "Hide me from the conspiracy of the wicked, from the plots of evildoers. They sharpen their tongues like swords and aim cruel words like deadly arrows. They shoot from ambush at the innocent. They shoot suddenly without fear." I declare over you that every ambush that the enemy has set up is being dismantled in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that the Lord is hiding you from the conspiracy of the wicked, and every cruel word spoken against you is being rendered powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. The arrows of the enemy will not find their mark. And I declare over you that the Lord is delivering you from every sudden attack in the name of Jesus. God's word in Psalm 91 verse 3 says, "Surely He will deliver you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence." I declare that the snare of the fowler is being broken in your life. Every trap that has been set to catch you, to trip you up, and to ensnare you is being destroyed by the hand of God. I declare that the Lord is saving you from every deadly pestilence, both spiritual and physical, in the name of Jesus. The enemy's schemes are being exposed, and I declare over you that you are walking in freedom, for the Lord is your deliverer, in the name of Jesus. According to Psalm 35 verses 1 to 3, "Contend, Lord, with those who contend with me. Fight against those who fight against me. Take up shield and armor. Arise and come to my aid. Brandish spear and javelin against those who pursue me. Say to me, I am your salvation." I declare that the Lord is contending with those who contend with you. I declare that God is taking up His shield and armor to fight on your behalf. Every pursuit of the enemy against your life is being cut off by the spear and javelin of the Lord. I declare over you that God is speaking directly to your heart, saying, "I am your salvation." And because of that, you will not fear. The word of the Lord in Psalm 37 verses 12 to 5 reminds us, "The wicked plot against the righteous and gnash their teeth at them, but the Lord laughs at the wicked. For He knows their day is coming. The wicked draw the sword and bend the bow to bring down the poor and needy, to slay those whose ways are upright. But their swords will pierce their own hearts, and their bows will be broken." I declare over you that the wicked schemes against you are turning back on themselves in the name of Jesus. Every sword that has been drawn against you will pierce the hearts of those who devise it, and every bow that has been bent to shoot at you will be broken. I declare over you that the Lord laughs at the wicked, for He knows their day of reckoning is coming. As it is written in Psalm 34 verse 7, "The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear Him, and He delivers them." I declare that the angel of the Lord is encamped around you, and you are being delivered from every plan of the enemy. I declare over you that the spiritual forces of heaven are fighting on your behalf, and no weapon formed against you will prosper. The evil schemes that have been working in secret are being exposed and destroyed By the power of the Most High God, I declare that divine protection surrounds you, and every attack of the enemy is being thwarted in the name of Jesus. According to God's word in Psalm 55 verses 9 to 11, which says, Lord, confuse the wicked, confound their words, for I see violence and strife in the city. Day and night they prowl about on its walls. Malice and abuse are within it. Destructive forces are at work in the city. Threats and lies never leave its streets. I declare over you that the Lord is confusing the wicked and confounding their words. Every destructive force that has been at work in your life is being dismantled. And I declare over you that the violence, malice, and abuse of the enemy are being stopped in their tracks in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that the threats and lies of the enemy are being exposed for what they truly are. Deceptions meant to steal your peace in Jesus' name. But I declare over you that the peace of God is overtaking you, and no lie of the enemy can stand in the face of God's truth in Jesus' name. The word of God in Psalm 59 verse 1 to 4, which says, Deliver me from my enemies, O God, be my fortress against those who are attacking me. Deliver me from evildoers and save me from those who are after my blood. See how they lie in wait for me. Fierce men conspire against me for no offense or sin of mine. Lord, I have done no wrong, yet they are ready to attack me. Arise to help me. Look on my plight. I declare over you that the Lord is arising to help you in the name of Jesus. Every attack against you that has been unjust and unwarranted is being brought before the throne of God. And I declare over you that justice is being served in your favor in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that the Lord is delivering you from your enemies and saving you from every evildoer who has conspired against you in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord is your fortress and you are safe in his arms. God's word in Psalm 140 verses 1 to 3. Rescue me, Lord, from evildoers. Protect me from the violent who devise evil plans in their heart and stir up war every day. They make their tongues as sharp as a serpent's. The poison of vipers is on their lips. I declare over you that the Lord is rescuing you from every evildoer and every violent person who has devised evil plans against you. I declare that the poisonous words of the enemy are losing their power and every evil plan is being exposed and destroyed in the name of Jesus. The enemy's schemes are no match for the power of God. And I declare over you that you are walking in victory over every plan of darkness that has come against you in the mighty name of Jesus. God's word in Psalm 94 verses 16 to 17 says, Who will rise up for me against the wicked? Who will take a stand for me against evildoers? Unless the Lord has given me help, I would soon have dwelt in the silence of death. I declare over you that the Lord is rising up for you against the wicked. I declare over you that the Lord is taking a stand on your behalf against every evildoer in the name of Jesus. You will not dwell in the silence of death, for the Lord has given you help. I declare over you that the voice of the Lord is speaking life and victory over every area where the enemy has tried to bring death and destruction in the name of Jesus. You are being lifted out of the pit, and the schemes of the enemy are being demolished in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, I declare over you that every scheme is being exposed and the plans of the enemy are being destroyed. Victory is yours, for the Lord fights for you and you are more than a conqueror in Christ. Understanding spiritual warfare, the reality of spiritual battles. I come before God acknowledging the reality of spiritual warfare. I declare over you that you are not alone in this battle in Jesus' name. You are equipped with the armor of God, and I declare that every fiery dart of the enemy will not pierce through your faith in the name of Jesus. I pray that you will stand firm in your identity as a child of God and that you will recognize the schemes of the enemy in the name of Jesus. I declare over you the strength to fight these battles, the wisdom to discern good from evil, and the courage to stand firm in your faith in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I declare that you will not be shaken by the adversary's lies or temptations. Amen. Biblical Foundations of Warfare Prayer. I thank God for the power of prayer and the authority we have in Christ. I declare over you that your prayer is your weapon, and I pray that you will harness this power daily in Jesus' name. May you find strength in your prayers and know that they reach the very throne of God in the name of Jesus. I declare that you will learn to pray fervently, believing in the promises of God. Let your prayers be rooted in scripture, and may you find comfort in the truth that God hears your every cry in Jesus' name. I pray that as you engage in warfare prayer, you will feel the closeness of God assuring you of his presence in every battle in Jesus' name. Recognizing the enemy's tactics, I declare over you that you will not be caught off guard by deception or distraction in Jesus' name. I pray for clarity in your mind and strength in your spirit to resist the lies of the enemy in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I declare that you have the discernment to see through the enemy's schemes. I pray that you will recognize when fear, doubt, or anxiety tries to creep into your heart. You are equipped with the truth of God's word, and I declare that it will guard your heart and mind in the name of Jesus. May you stand strong against every attack, knowing that you are more than a conqueror, through Christ in Jesus' name. Psalm 91, the promise of protection. Analyzing the text of Psalm 91. I thank God for the promises found in Psalm 91. I declare over you that as you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, you will find refuge under his wings in the name of Jesus. I pray that you will feel the warmth of his protection enveloping you in Jesus' name. I declare that every word of this psalm will resonate deeply within your spirit in Jesus' name. You will meditate on these promises and they will become your truth. As you read, "He is my refuge and my fortress," I pray that you will feel secure in his presence, knowing that you are safe from harm in Jesus' name. Key themes: refuge, faith, and deliverance. I declare over you the assurance of refuge in God in Jesus' name. You are safe, and I pray that you will run to him in times of trouble. I declare that you will cultivate a deep faith, rooted in the knowledge that God is your protector. May your faith grow stronger as you face challenges, knowing that God is always with you. I declare deliverance over every area of your life where you feel attacked in Jesus' name. You experience his power over your life, breaking every chain and releasing you from bondage. You are free, and I pray that you walk in that freedom daily in Jesus' name. Meditating on God's promises. I declare over you a spirit of meditation and reflection on God's word in Jesus' name. I pray that you will carve out time in your day to sit quietly and absorb the promises of Psalm 91. May these words bring you peace and comfort in Jesus' name. As you meditate, I declare that you will be filled with the Holy Spirit, guiding your thoughts and bringing revelation to your heart. I pray that these promises will not only be words on a page, but will become a living truth in your life. You are cherished, and God's promises are for you. Praying with confidence and authority, establishing your authority in Christ. I thank God for the authority we have through Christ. I declare over you that you are empowered by the Holy Spirit to tread upon serpents and scorpions. Luke 10:19, in the name of Jesus. You have authority over every spiritual attack, and I pray that you will exercise this authority boldly in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I declare that you will not live in fear or intimidation. You are a warrior in the kingdom of God, and I pray that you will walk in your divine authority. May you declare the promises of God with confidence, knowing that the battle is already won through Christ in Jesus' name. Crafting powerful warfare prayers. I declare over you that your prayers will be mighty and effective. James 5:16. I pray that as you pray, you will feel the power of the Holy Spirit walking through you in Jesus' name. I declare that you will not hesitate to speak the name of Jesus over every situation in your life in Jesus' name. May you declare with boldness, "I am protected, I am delivered, and I am victorious." I pray that your words will carry the weight of heaven, causing every demonic force to flee in the name of Jesus. Using scripture in prayer for protection. I declare over you that you will find strength and guidance in the word of God in Jesus' name. As you pray, may you incorporate verses from Psalm 91 and other passages, allowing them to saturate your prayers. I declare that you will speak God's word with authority. When you say, "No evil shall befall me, nor shall any plague come near my dwelling." Psalm 91 verse 10. I pray that you will feel the assurance of his protection in Jesus' name. May the scriptures you declare become a shield around you, guarding you against every attack of the enemy, in Jesus' name. Specific prayers for protection against attacks. Prayers against fear and anxiety. I declare over you that God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. That's 2 Timothy 1 verse 7. I pray that you will embrace this truth and let go of every fear that binds you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I declare that fear has no place in your life. I pray for the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, to guard your heart and mind. That's Philippians 4:7. You feel the weight of fear lift off your shoulders, replaced by a profound sense of peace and security in Christ, in Jesus' name. Prayers for protection from deception and lies. I thank God for His truth that sets us free. I declare over you that you will have the discernment to recognize lies and deception in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will expose any falsehoods in your life and replace them with His truth in the name of Jesus. I declare that you will walk in the light of God's word in Jesus' name. May you say, "I will not be swayed by the lies of the enemy," and stand firm in your faith. I pray that the Holy Spirit will guide you into all truth, John 16:13, and help you to identify any deceptions that may try to ensnare you in the name of Jesus. Prayers for deliverance from oppression. I declare over you that you are not bound by oppression. I pray that every chain that holds you back will be broken in the name of Jesus. I declare deliverance over your life. I pray that you will feel the weight of oppression lift and experience the joy of freedom in the name of Jesus. As you call upon the name of Jesus, I declare that every demonic force must flee. You are a child of God, and I pray that you will walk in the fullness of that identity in the name of Jesus. Strengthening your spiritual resilience, building a constant prayer life. I thank God for the gift of prayer. I declare over you that you will establish a consistent prayer life that draws you closer to God in Jesus' name. I pray that you will carve out time each day to communicate with Him, finding strength and guidance in His presence. I declare that your prayers will be powerful and transformative. As you dedicate time to pray, may you feel God's presence surrounding you, infusing you with peace and purpose in the name of Jesus. I pray that prayer will become your first response in every situation. In Jesus' name. Engaging in community and accountability. I thank God for the body of Christ and the strength we find in community. I declare over you that you will engage with fellow believers who will uplift and encourage you. I pray that you will seek out friendships that inspire spiritual growth and accountability in the name of Jesus. I declare that you will not walk this journey alone. May you find comfort in sharing your struggles and victories with others in Jesus' name. I pray that you will experience the joy of community, knowing that you are surrounded by people who love and support you in your walk with Christ in Jesus' name. Growing in faith through spiritual disciplines. I declare over you that you will actively engage in fasting, studying scripture, and worship. I pray that these practices will deepen your relationship with God and equip you for spiritual battles in Jesus' name. I declare that as you fast, you will draw closer to God, breaking strongholds in your life. May your time in scripture fill you with wisdom and understanding, and may your worship invite the presence of God into your heart in Jesus' name. You are being strengthened, and I pray that you will stand firm in your faith through these disciplines, Jesus' name. In conclusion, as we engage in warfare prayer for protection against spiritual attacks, let us remember the promises of Psalm 91. I declare over you that you are protected, empowered, and equipped to face every battle that comes your way in the name of Jesus. Embrace your authority in Christ, speak His word with confidence, and stand firm in your faith. May your prayers be powerful. May you find strength and comfort in the knowledge that God is with you every step of the way. You're more than a conqueror, and I declare that you will walk in victory and peace in Jesus' name. Psalm 91 is one of the most powerful scriptures for protection, a declaration of God's sovereignty and defense over His children. I declare over you today that no evil shall befall you and no plague shall come near your dwelling, as promised in Psalm 91 verse 10. As you put your trust in the Lord, may He send His angels to have charge over you, to keep you in all your ways. I declare over you that you shall not fear the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that walks in the darkness, nor the destruction that lays waste at noonday. The devil may try to bring fear, anxiety, and destruction into your life, but I declare that God is your refuge and fortress, your God in whom you trust. Psalm 91 verse 2. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Lord will lift up a standard against him. I declare over you that the Lord will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. I declare over you, Psalm 27, the devil thrives on fear, but Psalm 27 reminds us that the Lord is our light and salvation. Whom shall we fear? I declare over you that the Lord is the stronghold of your life. Of whom shall you be afraid? When the enemy seeks to steal your peace, I declare that your heart will be strengthened in the Lord, in the name of Jesus. Even when the wicked, the enemy comes against you to devour your flesh, they will stumble and fall. Though an army encamp against you, your heart will not fear. Though war arise against you, yet you will be confident. The devil's plans will not prosper against you, for God is your defender. I declare over you that you will dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of your life to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple in Jesus' name. In the day of trouble, may the Lord hide you in the shelter and set you high upon a rock. The devil's schemes cannot touch you when you are hidden in the secret place of the Most High. I declare over you, Psalm 34, the devil seeks to bind us in chains of sin, fear, oppression, but the psalmist declares the Lord as our deliverer. I declare over you that the angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him, and he delivers them. That's Psalm 34, verse 7. As you cry out to the Lord, may he hear you and deliver you from all your troubles. That's Psalm 34, verse 17. I declare that you will taste and see that the Lord is good, and as you take refuge in him, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open to their cry. Psalm 34, verse 15. I declare over you that the Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Psalm 34, verse 18. The afflictions of the righteous may be many, but the Lord delivers them out of them all. The devil's strongholds are broken, for you are delivered by the mighty hand of God. I declare over you that the devil's lies, deceptions, and attacks have no power over your life, because the Lord redeems the soul of his servants, and none of those who take refuge in him will be condemned. I declare over you, Psalm 23, the enemy seeks to rob us of our peace and confidence, but the Lord, as our shepherd, leads us beside still waters and restores our souls. I declare over you that you lack nothing, for the Lord is your shepherd in Jesus' name. Even when the devil tries to lead you into confusion or despair, the Lord leads you into the paths of righteousness for his name's sake, in Jesus' name. I declare over you that even though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you will fear no evil, for the Lord is with you. His rod and his staff, they comfort you. The devil may try to bring darkness, but the presence of the Lord illuminates your path and protects you from all harm in Jesus' name. I declare that the Lord prepares a table before you in the presence of your enemies, and he anoints your head with oil, your cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy will follow you all the days of your life, and you will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I declare over you Psalm 46 in times of spiritual battle. When it feels like the foundations are shaken, I declare over you that God is your refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Even though the earth gives way and the mountains are moved into the heart of the sea, you will not fear, for the Lord of hosts is with you. The devil's threats cannot shake your trust in the Almighty. I declare over you that there is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. God will help out when the morning dawns. The nations may rage and kingdoms may totter, but when the Lord utters his voice, the earth melts. I declare over you that the Lord of hosts is with you. The God of Jacob is your fortress. That's Psalm 46, verses 6 to 7, in Jesus' name. Be still and know that he is God. The devil's attempts to cause chaos and fear in your life are silenced by the power of God's word. I declare over you that God will be exalted amongst the nations, and he will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with you, and you are safe under his mighty wings in Jesus' name. I declare over you Psalm 56. The enemy often uses fear as a tactic to keep us bound, but the psalmist declares trust in God in the face of fear. I declare over you that when you are afraid, you will put your trust in God. In God whose word you praise, you will not fear. What can flesh do to you? The devil's attempts to instill fear will fail, for your confidence is in the Lord. I declare over you that the Lord keeps count of your tossings and puts your tears in his bottle. When the devil tries to bring sorrow, remember that God is attentive to every cry. I declare that your enemies will turn back when you call to the Lord. This you know, for God is within you. Fear has no place in your heart, for the Lord is on your side. In God, whose word you praise, you will not be afraid. What can man or the devil do to you? I declare over you that the vows you made to the Lord will be fulfilled, and you will offer thanks offering to God. He has delivered your soul from death, your feet from falling, that you may walk before God in the light of life. The devil's hold is fulfilled, and you will offer thank offerings to God. He has delivered your soul from death, your feet from falling, that you may walk before God in the light of life. The devil's hold is broken, for God has delivered you in Jesus' name. I declare over you Psalm 121. The devil seeks to make us feel helpless and isolated, but I declare over you that your help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. When the enemy tries to overwhelm you, I declare that the Lord will not let your foot be moved, and he who keeps you will not slumber. I declare over you that the Lord will keep your going out and coming in from this time forth and forevermore. The devil's plans to steal, kill, and destroy are thwarted by the Lord's divine protection and help. I declare over you Psalm 18, when the enemy seeks to oppress, I declare that the Lord is your rock, your fortress, and your deliverer. I declare that you will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, and you will be saved from your enemies in Jesus' name. I declare over you that no plan of the enemy can prevail, because the Lord is your refuge and strong fortress. In Psalm 91 verse 2, the psalmist says, I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I will trust. When the enemy devises plots and schemes to harm you, remember that you are hidden in the safety of the Almighty. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. I declare over you that the Lord is your refuge and your fortress. And as you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, the enemy's traps will be revealed and destroyed. The refuge of God is impenetrable, and no evil can break through to reach you. The Lord promises to protect those who trust in him. Psalm 91 verse 3 continues, surely he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. The enemy may attempt to ensnare you with traps and hidden dangers, but I declare over you that the Lord will deliver you from every snare. The fowler's trap will be broken, and you will escape every plan designed to bring you harm. Psalm 91 verse 5 to 6 promises, you will not fear the terror of night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor of the plague that destroys at midday. I declare over you that the arrows of the enemy will not strike you, whether they come as fear, illness, or spiritual attacks. The Lord's shield of protection is upon you, and every fiery dart of the enemy is extinguished by the shield of faith. The enemy might launch attacks in your direction, but the word of God guarantees that they will not hit their target. Psalm 91 verse 7 continues, 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. I declare over you that even when destruction is all around, it will not come near you. The Lord's hand of protection is upon you, keeping you safe from harm. I declare over you that as you lift up the name of the Lord in prayer and praise, the enemies that come against you will be scattered. The presence of God cannot coexist with evil, and as you invite his presence into your life, every enemy must flee. As God arises in your life, the forces of darkness will be disbanded and the power of the enemy will be broken. I declare over you that every spiritual adversary, whether it is in the form of oppression, sickness, or fear, will be scattered in the mighty name of Jesus. You are victorious through the power of God, and the forces of evil will not stand against you in Jesus' name. The enemy is always devising plans to derail the purposes of God in your life. However, Psalm 33 verse 10 declares, the Lord foils the plans of the nations. He thwarts the purposes of the peoples. I declare over you that every plan of the enemy will be frustrated and brought to nothing. The Lord himself will thwart and cancel every scheme aimed at your destruction. Where the enemy has plotted to bring confusion and turmoil, the Lord will bring peace and clarity. Psalm 37 verses 12 to 13 confirms this, saying, the wicked plots against the righteous and gnash their teeth at them, but the Lord laughs at the wicked, for he knows their day is coming. I declare over you that the Lord will laugh at the schemes of the wicked on your behalf. The plots and plans of the enemy are futile in the face of God's power. As you trust in the Lord and commit your way to him, he will bring every evil work to nothing. In Psalm 91 verses 11 to 12, the Bible assures us, "For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. I declare over you that the angelic hosts of heaven are fighting on your behalf. The enemy's plans will fail because the angels of the Lord are sent to protect and guard you in all your ways. Even when the enemies seek to harm you in subtle and hidden ways, God's angels are watching over you. They will lift you up, preventing you from stumbling and carry you to safety. I declare over you that the enemy's ambushes will be foiled because the Lord has already dispatched his angels to guard your path." Psalm 34 verse 17 declares, "The righteous cry out and the Lord hears them. He delivers them from all their troubles. I declare over you that the Lord is your deliverer and he will rescue you from every scheme of the enemy. No matter what trouble or hardship the enemy tries to bring into your life, the Lord's arm is not too short to save. He will reach down into your situation and pull you out of every pit in Jesus' name." Psalm 34 verse 19 reminds us, "The righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers him from them all." I declare over you that though the enemy may try to burden you with many troubles, the Lord will deliver you from every single one. His power to save and rescue is greater than the enemy's ability to harm in Jesus' name. The enemy often tries to attack through lies, accusations, and slander, but Psalm 31 verse 18 says, "Let their lying lips be silenced, for with pride and contempt they speak arrogantly against the righteous." I declare over you that every lying and accusing voice raised against you will be silenced. The enemy is known as the accuser of the brethren, but his accusations have no power over a child of God. I declare over you that every word spoken against you in deceit, every false accusation, and every attack on your character will be brought to nothing. The truth of God will prevail in your life, and the voice of the enemy will be silenced. Psalm 110 verse 1 proclaims, "The Lord says to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet." I declare over you that the Lord will make your enemies a footstool under your feet. Just as Christ has crushed the head of the serpent, so too will the Lord crush the enemies that rise against you. Every demonic force, every spiritual attack, and every oppressive scheme will be defeated in Jesus' name. I declare over you that the authority given to you in Christ will render the enemy powerless in your life. Luke 10:19 confirms this. "I have given you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions and to overcome all the power of the enemy. Nothing will harm you. You will walk in victory, and the Lord will ensure that your enemies are subdued beneath your feet in Jesus' name." Psalm 18 verse 39 declares, "You armed me with strength for battle. You humbled my adversaries before me." I declare over you that the Lord will strengthen you for every battle you face. No matter how fierce the warfare may seem, the Lord is equipping you with divine strength to overcome. The enemy's forces will be humbled before you and victory will be your portion. In Psalm 18 verse 32, the psalmist says, "It is God who arms me with strength and keeps my way secure." I declare over you that God himself is your strength. The battles you face are not yours alone, for the Lord is fighting for you. He will give you the power to stand, and no force of darkness will be able to prevail against you in Jesus' name. Psalm 23 verse 4 comforts us with the words, "Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me." I declare over you that even in the darkest moments, the Lord is with you and the enemy cannot bring fear into your heart. His presence is your comfort and your guide, and his rod and staff will lead you out of every valley in Jesus' name. Though the enemy may try to bring darkness and despair, I declare over you that you will fear no evil. The Lord's light will shine upon your path and it will lead you through every trial in Jesus' name. Today, I declare over you that the enemy's schemes will be scattered, his plans destroyed, and his attacks will fail. The Lord will scatter every plan of the enemy in all ramifications of your life. God's word in Psalm 91 declares, "He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I declare over you that you are securely hidden in the secret place of the Most High, where no enemy can penetrate, in Jesus' name. The shadow of the Almighty is your shield, safeguarding you from every adversary and spiritual attack, in Jesus' name. I declare over you that every scheme, plan, and attack of the enemy is thwarted by the overwhelming protection of God. The Lord's shadow covers you, making you invulnerable to the weapons formed against you. No matter how the enemy tries to approach, I declare over you that he will find you completely protected under the divine canopy of the Almighty, in Jesus' name. I declare over you that the Lord is your refuge and your fortress in the midst of spiritual warfare. Psalm 91 verse 2 says, I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him I will trust. I declare over you that as you trust in the Lord, He becomes your fortress against every attack of the enemy, in Jesus' name. I declare that every enemy, whether visible or invisible, is met with the impenetrable defense of the Lord, in Jesus' name. The fortress of God is strong and unyielding, and no enemy can breach its walls. The Lord's protection is comprehensive, covering every aspect of your life. I declare over you that no weapon forged by the enemy can succeed against the fortress that God has established around you, in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that the Lord delivers you from every snare of the enemy. Psalm 91 verse 3 promises, surely He shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. I declare over you that every trap set by the enemy to ensnare you is dismantled by the Lord's intervention, in Jesus' name. The snares of deception, deceit, and malevolence laid out by your enemies are exposed and rendered powerless. I declare that the Lord's deliverance is active and effective, rescuing you from every plot and scheme designed to harm you, in Jesus' name. The perilous pestilence that seeks to destroy you is neutralized by God's divine protection. You are free from the traps of the enemy, walking in the liberty and safety provided by your deliverer, in Jesus' name. I declare over you that you are covered with the Lord's protective wings, making you safe from every attack of the enemy, in Jesus' name. Psalm 91 verse 4 declares, He shall cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. I declare over you that the Lord's wings provide a comprehensive shield against every assault from the enemy, in Jesus' name. The feathers of divine protection create an impenetrable barrier, keeping all forms of spiritual and physical harm at bay. I declare over you that the truth of God's word acts as a powerful shield, deflecting the arrows of falsehood, fear, and intimidation aimed at you by the enemy, in Jesus' name. You are enveloped by God's wings, secure and protected from all the adversarial plans of the darkness, in Jesus' name. I declare over you that you will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, in Jesus' name. Psalm 91 verses 5 to 6 states, You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. I declare over you that fear has no place in your life, because the Lord's protection is comprehensive and all-encompassing. When the enemy's attacks come under the cover of darkness or in the brightness of day, I declare over you that you are shielded from every form of assault by the enemy, in Jesus' name. The terror of the night, the arrows of hostility, and the destructive forces that aim to overwhelm you are all defeated by the Lord's mighty hand. I declare over you that you walk in fearless confidence, knowing that the Lord's protection surrounds you in every situation, in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that even if 1,000 fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, it shall not come near you. Psalm 91 verses 7 to 8 asserts, 1,000 may fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Only with your eyes you shall look and see the reward of the wicked. I declare over you that the Lord's protection is so powerful that you remain untouched even in the midst of widespread calamity and destruction. The plans of your enemies, however numerous, cannot affect you, because you are under God's divine shield. I declare over you that you will witness the defeat of the wicked, but remain unscathed, in Jesus' name. I declare over you that no evil shall befall you and no plague shall come near your dwelling. Psalm 91 verses 9 to 10 declares, because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. I declare over you that by making the Lord your refuge and dwelling place, you have secured his protection over every aspect of your life in Jesus' name. The evil schemes of your enemies and the plagues they wish to send your way are neutralized by the Lord's intervention. I declare over you that your dwelling is sanctified by the presence of God, ensuring that no harm or danger can enter in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that the Lord's angels are assigned to guard you and protect you from every attack of the enemy in Jesus' name. Psalm 91 verses 11 to 12 says, "For he shall give his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. In their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone." I declare over you that the Lord has dispatched his angels to watch over you, ensuring that every attack of the enemy is intercepted in Jesus' name. These divine beings are your protectors, lifting you up and preventing any harm from coming near you. I declare over you that the angels are actively engaged in safeguarding you from every threat, and their presence ensures that you are upheld in every situation in the name of Jesus. I declare over you that you have been given authority to trample upon every adversary and every spiritual force of darkness in Jesus' name. Psalm 91 verse 13 states, "You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, the young lion and the serpent you shall trample underfoot." I declare over you that the power of God within you enables you to overcome every adversary that the enemy sends your way. The lion, the cobra, and the serpent, symbols of the enemy's power and deception, are all under your feet. I declare over you that you have authority to defeat every attack of the enemy and to destroy every weapon formed against you. The power of Jesus Christ enables you to walk in victory over every spiritual force that seeks to harm you in Jesus' name. I declare over you that the Lord will deliver and honor you because of your love for him. Psalm 91 verse 14 declares, "Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high because he has known my name." I declare over you that the Lord's love for you is the basis for his deliverance and protection. Because you have set your love upon the Lord, he will deliver you from every attack, every scheme, and every plan of the enemy. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. The secret place is where God's presence resides. It is a place of intimacy and communion with the Father. When you choose to dwell in this place, you are positioning yourself under the shadow of the Almighty, where no evil can harm you. I declare over you that you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, where no evil or darkness can touch you. May you find safety and refuge under the shadow of the Almighty as you abide in his presence. May every evil force that seeks to disrupt your peace be dismantled in the name of Jesus. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him I will trust. Here the psalmist makes a bold declaration of trust in God. When we acknowledge that God is our refuge and fortress, we are affirming that he is the one who defends and protects us. I declare over you that the Lord is your refuge and fortress. No weapon formed against you will prosper, and no evil will be able to breach the stronghold that God has built around you. Trust in him and watch as it dismantles every scheme of the enemy on your behalf. Verse 3, "Surely he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence." The snare of the fowler represents traps and deceptions set by the enemy. The perilous pestilence symbolizes diseases and plagues that may come to destroy. But God's promise is sure he will deliver you from every evil plot and from every form of danger. I declare over you that every snare that the enemy has set for you will be exposed and dismantled by the power of God. No pestilence, no disease, no trap will succeed in your life. The Lord will deliver you from every hidden danger and make you victorious over every evil force. He shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. The imagery of God covering you with his feathers speaks of his tender protection, much like a mother bird sheltering her young under her wings. His truth acts as your defense, keeping you safe from the lies and the attacks of the enemy. I declare over you that God's protective wings are covering you, and under his feathers you are safe from all harm. His truth surrounds you like a shield, blocking every lie and attack from the enemy. No evil force will be able to penetrate the fortress that God has built around you. Verse 5. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day. This verse addresses fear and anxiety, especially during times of uncertainty. Whether it's the terror of the night or the arrows of the day, God promises that you will not be afraid because he is your protector. I declare over you that fear will not take hold of your life. The terror of the night and the arrows of the day have no power over you because God is your shield. May the peace of God dismantle every evil force that seeks to bring fear and anxiety into your life. Walk boldly knowing that you are protected by the Almighty. Verse 6. Not of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. This verse addresses hidden dangers, pestilence and destructions that operate in the unseen realms. Whether it's diseases or sudden destruction, God's protection is comprehensive, covering you day and night. I declare over you that no hidden danger will have power over you. The pestilence that walks in darkness and the destruction that seeks to harm you will be dismantled by the power of God. Every plot of the enemy that works in secret will be exposed and defeated in Jesus' name. Verse 7. 1,000 may fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. This verse speaks to the overwhelming protection of God. Even in the midst of chaos, when others are falling to the left and to the right, God's hand of protection will keep you safe. I declare over you that even though 1,000 may fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, it will not come near you. No evil will come near you. You are set apart by God, and his protective shield will keep you from harm. Every evil force that rises against you will fall, and you will remain standing strong in the Lord in Jesus' name. Verse 8. Only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the wicked. God promises that his justice will prevail. You will witness the downfall of the wicked and the dismantling of the evil forces that oppose you, but they will not touch you. I declare over you that you will see the defeat of your enemies with your own eyes. The Lord will execute his judgment on those who rise against you, and you will witness the dismantling of every evil force that seeks to harm you. Stand firm knowing that God's justice is on your side. Verse 9 to 10. Because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. When you make God your dwelling place, his promise is that no evil will befall you, and no plague will come near your dwelling, and no plague will come near your home in Jesus' name. This is a powerful declaration of divine protection over your household. I declare over you that no evil shall come near your home, and you and your household are covered by the blood of Jesus, and every evil force that seeks to invade your dwelling will be dismantled. No plague, no disaster, no harm will touch your family, for the Lord is your refuge and fortress in Jesus' name. Verses 11 to 12. For he shall give his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. In their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. God has commissioned his angels to watch over you. They will guard you in every situation, lifting you up and protecting you from harm. I declare over you that God's angels are surrounding you, protecting you from every danger. They will lift you up and keep you from stumbling. Every evil force that seeks to bring harm to your life will be dismantled by the angelic armies that fight on your behalf in Jesus' name. You are not alone. Divine protection is with you. Verse 13, you shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, the young lion and the serpent you shall trample underfoot. This verse speaks of authority over evil. The lion and the cobra represent fierce and subtle dangers, but God promises that you will tread upon them, meaning you will have victory over every force that opposes you in Jesus' name. I declare over you that you will trample over every evil force that rises against you. Whether it comes in the form of a fierce attack or a subtle deception, you will have victory. The power of the enemy is under your feet, and you will walk in the authority given to you by Christ Jesus. Verse 14, because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high because he knows my name. God promises deliverance to those who love him and who know his name. When you call upon his name, he responds with protection and deliverance from all evil. I declare over you that because you have set your love upon God, he will deliver you from every evil force. He will lift you up and set you on high above the reach of your enemies. No scheme of the enemy will prevail against you, for you have known the name of the Lord, and his name is your strong tower. Verse 15. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. God hears your prayers. When you call upon him, he promises to answer and to be with you in times of trouble. Not only will he deliver you, but he will also honor you. I declare over you that every time you call upon the Lord, he will answer you. He will be with you in times of trouble and he will deliver you from every evil force that seeks to destroy you. God will not only save you, but he will also honor you before your enemies. May you experience his presence and his power in every situation in Jesus' name. Verse 16, with long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. God's promise of long life and salvation is the final word. He guarantees that his protection will not only give you victory over every evil forces. Heavenly Father, thank you for dismantling every evil forces. I declare over you that the truths in this psalm will fortify your faith and empower you to stand firm in spiritual battles. In this opening verses, David reflects on how God delivered him from a place of despair. In spiritual warfare, patience and trust in God's timing are vital. When you are under attack or in a season of hardship, it can feel like you are trapped in a miry pit. The enemy thrives in sowing seeds of fear, doubt, and discouragement during these times. Yet, I declare over you that as you wait on the Lord, he will hear your cry and pull you out of the pit. The Lord will place your feet on solid ground, stabilizing you amidst the storms of life in Jesus' name. He will replace your sorrow with a song of victory that will inspire others to trust in him. This passage also serves as a reminder that spiritual warfare is not fought solely by physical means, but through praise, patience, and trust in God. I declare over you that as you sing the praises of God, the forces of darkness will be pushed back and many will come to trust in the Lord through your testimony of victory in Jesus' name. Psalm 40 verses 4 to 5. Blessed is the man who makes the Lord his trust, who does not turn to the proud, to those who go astray after a lie. You have multiplied, O Lord my God, your wondrous deeds and your thoughts towards us. None can compare with you. I will proclaim and tell of them, yet they are more than can be told. These verses highlight the importance of trusting in God rather than seeking human solutions or turning to false sources of hope. In the heat of spiritual warfare, the temptation to rely on worldly wisdom, pride, or deceitful solutions can be strong. The enemy seeks to lure people away from God's truth by offering counterfeit alternatives. But I declare over you that you will not be led astray by lies. You will keep your focus on the Lord, trusting in his power and wisdom to guide you through every battle. God's thoughts towards his people are countless and his deeds are wondrous. I declare over you that in the midst of spiritual warfare, you will be reminded of God's faithfulness in your life. As you reflect on his past deeds, your faith will be strengthened and you will stand firm knowing that the same God who delivered you before will deliver you again. Your testimony will be a weapon against the enemy, for the word of God declares in Revelations 12:11 that they triumphed over him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. Psalm 40 verses 6 to 8, in sacrifice and offering, you have not delighted, but you have given me an open ear. Burnt offering and sin offering you do not require. Then I said, behold, I have come in the scroll of the book. It is written of me. I delight to do your will, O my God. Your law is within my heart. These verses emphasize the importance of obedience over mere religious rituals. Spiritual warfare is not just about prayers or declarations. It is about aligning oneself with God's will. I declare over you that as you fight spiritual battles, your heart will be fully aligned with God's purposes in Jesus' name. You will not rely on empty rituals, but on a deep personal relationship with God. The law of the Lord will be written on your heart, guarding you in truth and righteousness. Obedience is a key component of spiritual warfare. When you live in alignment with God's will, you place yourself under His divine protection. I declare over you that as you delight in doing the will of God, the schemes of the enemies will be nullified. The enemy cannot prevail where there is obedience to God, for obedience releases divine authority and power. Psalm 40 verses 9 to 10, I have told the glad news of deliverance in the great congregation. Behold, I have not restrained my lips, as you know, O Lord. I have not hidden your deliverance within my heart. I have spoken of your faithfulness and salvation. I have not concealed your steadfast love and your faithfulness from the great congregation. In the midst of spiritual warfare, there is a great power in proclaiming the goodness and faithfulness of God. David boldly declares that he did not hide the deliverance of the Lord, but spoke of it openly. I declare over you that you will be a bold proclaimer of God's faithfulness. Even in the midst of trials, the enemy desires to silence believers, but your testimony will break chains and bring others to faith. As you declare the deliverance of the Lord, your words carry the power of the Holy Spirit, pushing back darkness and lifting up the name of Jesus. There is authority in speaking the word of God and testifying about His goodness. In Revelations 12:11, the Bible tells us that we overcome the enemy by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. I declare over you that your testimony will be a weapon of warfare, and your proclamations will open the door for divine intervention and deliverance. Psalm 40 verses 11 to 13, As for you, O Lord, you will not restrain your mercy from me. Your steadfast love and your faithfulness will ever preserve me, for evils have encompassed me beyond number. My iniquities have overtaken me and I cannot see. They are more than the hairs of my head. My heart fails me. Be pleased, O Lord, to deliver me. O Lord, make haste to help me. In spiritual warfare, it is essential to cry out to God for help. David acknowledges the overwhelming nature of the battle, but also affirms God's unrestrained mercy and love. I declare over you that in your times of greatest need, God's mercy will be abundant and His love unfailing. Though the enemy surrounds you and the weight of sin or spiritual attack feels heavy, the Lord will be swift to deliver you. Psalm 40 verses 14 to 15, Let those be put to shame and disappointed altogether who seek to snatch away my life. Let those be turned back and brought to dishonor who delight in my heart. Let those be appalled because of their scheme who say to me, Aha, aha, in these verses. David prays for the defeat of his enemies. Spiritual warfare often involves facing attacks from the enemy who seeks to destroy, discourage, and harm God's people. I declare over you that every plan of the enemy to harm you will be brought to shame and disappointment. Those who seek to harm your life, whether through spiritual or physical means, will be turned back and brought to dishonor. The enemy may come with accusations and attempts to bring shame, but I declare over you that God will vindicate you in Jesus' name. The word of God says in Isaiah 54:17, No weapon formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue that rises against you in judgment you shall condemn. I declare that every plot against you will fail, and those who delight in your heart will be appalled by the power of God working in your life. Psalm 40 verses 16 to 17, But may all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. May those who love your salvation say continually, Great is the Lord. As for me, I am poor and needy, but the Lord takes thought for me. You are my help, my deliverer. Do not delay, O my God. In the final verses of this psalm, David shifts his focus to joy and worship. In spiritual warfare, joy in the Lord becomes a powerful weapon. The enemy seeks to steal our joy and fill our hearts with fear and discouragement. But I declare over you that your joy will remain steadfast in the Lord. You will continually declare, great is the Lord, because you know that he is your help and deliverer. Though you may feel poor and needy at times, God takes thought for you. I declare over you that the Lord is mindful of your battles, and he will not delay in coming to your aid. His deliverance will be swift, and your joy will be full because of his salvation. Thank you, Father, for answered prayers. In Jesus' name, amen.